today I want to encourage each one of us and let us know that Scripture has something to say as we journey through these seasons. It calls us to be faithful to the end. Faithfulness has different kinds of meanings, but the meaning that we are going to be looking at is to understand that being faithful is to be steadfast or consistent in any commitment or affection. So a faithful person does not waver. A faithful person is always there and is someone you can actually depend on. Being faithful to the end really means how you are steadfast and consistent in spite of times that may be difficult. Because that's what proves our faithfulness. Despite what we are going through, do we continue to being faithful? Are we continue being faithful to the end? Jesus demonstrated perfect faithfulness in God the Father. He demonstrated perfect faithfulness in God the Father. We should look to Jesus because he's faithful in his person. He is called the high priest and the apostle of our confession. So he is faithful in his person. He is also faithful in his position to bring us, his house, his people, unto the glory of God because of what he did on the cross. Let's look at certain things from what we have understood from the Israelites. Couple of things that actually hinders us when we walk in towards faithfulness: unbelief and doubt. So doubt is one of faith's greatest enemies. Doubt can hinder us. It ravages our faith, and most of all, it displeases God. Unbelief has a potential to keep us from being faithful. The Israelites complained about everything. They complained of their lack of food, their lack of meat, their lack of water. They complained about Moses. They complained about God. So we know that complaining reaps consequences. It reaps results. It reaps a walk of faithlessness, of being unfaithful. So we need to be careful about every time we think of something. Is it worth it to complain and not giving thanks? Paying heed to discouraging reports. So if our eyes are not fixed on God, our problems will probably look much taller and much bigger. So it is important for us to have our senses and our minds controlled from the reports that we hear in and around us. Sin and disobedience. Sin chokes our faith. It alienates us from God. In fact, the fundamental factor that kept God away from man was disobedience, right at the Garden of Eden. So we are called to be in obedience to God, because when we are in obedience to God, we walk a walk of faith. God delights to walk us into our spiritual inheritance when we remain faithful to him and his promises. Let's look into how is it that we can grow into being faithful to the end. So how does our faithfulness come about? First way that our faithfulness does come about is out of our love for God. Our faithfulness also comes out when we immerse in God's word. Our faith grows because it is one of the fruits of the Spirit. Being faithful to God is not a feeling. It is a choice. Let's look into our next section of what are the promises that God gives us when we remain faithful to him. We are partakers of Christ. The other promise that we are given is that we will be richly blessed. When we are faithful, we are richly blessed. We also see that another promise is that we dwell with God. The other promise that God gives us is that he acts on our behalf. And the last promise that we are given is that we will be given a crown of life. Now, as we move into our last section, we need to also know of what should our response be. How do we persevere in times like this and continue to be faithful to the end? So the first is to be able to give thanks. Rejoice in the Lord. To be patient. Faithfulness requires patience. Another important thing as we persevere is to be able to take our faith boosters. Taking our faith boosters. Our faith boosters is the Word of God. And lastly, it is to call on Him. We need to continue to remain faithful in the knowledge that He will hear us, He will deliver us, He will pick us up, and He will take us from day to day, because He is a God who promised to be faithful.